Hello and welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you a new feature in Google Sites, which allows you to build your own custom theme. So you can really make it personalized, use your own logo, badges, banners, colors, however you want things to look, you have a lot more flexibility than in the past. So if you are a familiar user of Google Sites, you know that Google Sites is amazing. It's a really easy tool to build websites. Lots of different purposes and roles for a school district. You can use Google Sites maybe as a place to communicate common homework assignments for maybe your team if you're in that type of setting. It's helpful for extracurriculars and clubs because it can be public and public facing, so everyone can access it. It's also great for projects too. If you want to give students the option to really learn some of these website building skills that are important for a lot of different career paths in the future and educational pathways, this is a great way to do that. It can help students organize their information and past projects, almost like an e-portfolio. It can serve as a really safe blogging tool as well, because a lot of blogging tools that are out there that are pretty amazing and pretty great, there are great options. A lot of them require users be of a certain age, and those ages don't usually fall into the age range of our elementary, middle, or high school students. So this could be an alternative for that. Furthermore, Google Sites can be a really great place for you to build escape rooms, digital breakouts, and all of that fun. If you are interested in that type of training, I do have a whole entire Google webinar focused on Google Sites and ways to use it in a classroom setting that I have linked on my page. So if you're curious about that, go for it. You can earn a professional growth point for attending that virtual training. But what I'm going to focus on right now is the awesome feature that was just added maybe about 2 months ago for all users in Google, and that is the ability to build your own custom theme. So if you're new to Google Sites, you go to sites.google.com. It's also in your Google Apps menu, although it's usually a little bit hidden. It's further down this little waffle page here, depending on how often you use it. So I have some samples right here that I've already built. These are all of the different sites that I've tinkered around and played with. You have some suggested templates right here that you can start from. There's even more if you click the arrows. If you have some in your organization, those are also there. But if you want to start from scratch, you just click the plus button. And we're going into our Google Sites Builder here. And whenever this loads, you have some options here on the right panel to decide your theme. So if you're familiar with Google Sites, then you know that these are the only themes that have been there for quite some time. So about 6 of them that you can pick from, and you have a little bit more options here if you select a theme, because you can pick some of the colors across the top. Now, the new thing is this piece right here, this little bubble, and that's what allows you to make this custom to whatever colors, images, icons, logo designs that you would like to have featured on your site, so it looks a little bit more consistent, professional, and clean. So if I click this little plus button, there's a little pop-up menu that will appear. So if you name your theme, that's really helpful, because when you build additional sites, you can apply the same theme to them. So if you're wanting to use a consistent theme for your school, an organization, or a club from year to year, and you're having to build more than one site, I would recommend doing this so that you can easily find it as you need to in the future. So I'm just going to name it that. This is going to be my new favorite theme, I guess. Okay, so the next thing I can do is add a logo. And this will be featured on your website in the corner and then also across the bottom navigation menu. So if I click upload, I'm going to select one that I've already downloaded on my device. And we're going to go with this one. All right. And then I can decide a banner image here. So a banner is this dark purple color that you see right here. That is what would be on the background of my header screen. So if I have a specific option that I would like to do there, I can do select. I can pull something out of my drive if I need to. And you can do the same technically with the logo. I could do a Google image search if I would like to as well. I can pull up my Google photos, or if I find something that I can reuse on the web, can also do that. But let's imagine that I just want to upload one that I already have on my device. We're going to do that, and we're going to do, we are going to use this little floral one. All right. And then I click the next button. So here is where I get to decide some of these different colors. So these are Google's presets. I want to do custom colors. I can decide those now. Now, what it did is it actually pulled some similar colors off of the two images I just uploaded, and that's where these preset colors came from. Although some of these are pretty standard for Google, every time you upload a picture, it's going to give you a couple that are the same, but it pulled some based off of what I uploaded. If you're really into making this even fancier, you can technically enter in the hex numbers, which are pretty commonly used across web design and graphic design. If you're into that, you'll see these across different websites, and you can build your palette there. I do have a really helpful website if you are wanting to build your own palette and see colors that work together and get those hex numbers so you can just enter and type them in. There's this really awesome website called coolers.co. It's spelled kind of funny, but when I go here, I can use it for free and it just generates colors that look really well together. And then I can copy and paste those different hex keys right here and it will automatically put the color in. All you need is that number. So if I've already decided on my color scheme, I'm gonna click next. And then this is where I can make it even more fancy and I have a little bit more control. So you have title fonts and heading fonts, and then you have your body text font. So you can select ones that are pretty readable. Again, if you're wanting to get some expertise on which ones are gonna look well together, Google has a whole entire font area that you can get to. If you just type in fonts.google.com, it pops up and gives you some suggestions here. General rule of thumb is don't use tons of serif fonts in your body text. Use sans serif because those are typically easier to read on the web than those with serif. So serif fonts are ones that have little special marks on the end of the letters. That's the serif. Sans serif does not have that. So that's actually how this is set up right now. These are actually both sans serif. But if I want to change my title to be something a little bit more fancy, we're going to go with that. Whenever I'm finished, I click create theme. And it does take it a second, as you're noticing, watching me sit here and stare at the screen with you. And there we go. We have my page made. So it looks super pretty. You can move things around if you need to. You can even change your picture here if you decide you don't like that. If you click this little button here, this is your background image, is your header. But you can even adjust. By default, it always checks this box that says adjust for readability, which means that sometimes it will alter the color of your header image here and its transparency, so it's easier for you to read the text. That's on by default for a reason, because it's helpful. It makes it better for your readers on your website. You can also upload a favicon, which is always going to show that little icon at the top of the tab if you would like to do that. So those are just some of the fun options that exist now in Google Sites. If you're really into those type of fun things in graphic design, I hope you think this is exciting. You can really have all the creativity and flexibility you want now that you can put your own fonts, colors, and pictures and logos on there. So have fun and let me know if you have any questions. Thank you.